On Valentine's Day, we say, "Be mine."
We present flowers and handwritten notes.
Some people even serenade.
Why?
Because love begins in our eyes and our ears.
And love resides not in the heart,
but in the brain, says neuroscientist Sarah Woolley at Columbia's Zuckerman Institute. She studies songbirds with courtship rituals that would wow even Romeo and Juliet. And those birds have a lot to teach us about how we communicate.
A male sings a loud, elaborate, and highly precise song to show the female that he has a healthy brain and a strong body. The qualities of the song are so important to his chances of mating that he has a special network in the brain devoted to constructing and performing the song. A female finch doesn't have this brain network. This is the biggest difference between male and female brains known to science. She has a special auditory system with finely tuned neurons that analyze every teeny tiny bit of the song to judge the quality of the male. She won't settle for anything less than the most sophisticated performance. It pays to be picky because finches mate for life. Both male and female work together to raise the offspring. A young male learns his song from his father. He must learn to sing in his first 90 days. If he doesn't, he never will, and the female finches will have nothing to do with him. Similarly, children must learn language before puberty, or they never will. Studying how finches learn to sing helps us to explore how we learn speech and how to help children with developmental disorders overcome speech impairments. Although we use our voices and hearing differently, humans and songbirds are both social creatures, and communication is fundamental to all aspects of our lives. The songs of birds remind us that speech is not just sound we make with our voices, it's how two brains connect to become a pair.